Hey, Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, what's in store for your December 2024 money, career, and business life? We're gonna dive in with the tarot, talk a little astrology, and find out. So keep watching. So welcome to the channel, or welcome back, Gemini. Awesome to see you here. So first, let's discuss important astrology that you need to be aware of in terms of your money, career, and business life for December 2024. We have Venus the first 7 days in Capricorn, which is your eighth house of other people's money, debts, taxes, investments, mortgages, all of that, inheritances, all of that type of money scenarios. We have Mercury, your ruling energy, retrograde until December 15th in the sign of Sagittarius. Sagittarius is your seventh house of other people, business or personal relationships. Okay, so the first week of December, there may be things going on in terms of people contacting you from your past to wrap up those areas I just mentioned. You may be hearing from your investment advisor, your tax person, your accountant. You may be hearing from somebody from your past about a debt or a mortgage or some other type of paperwork like that. All those areas I mentioned before. Because of course, Mercury retrograde in our seventh house can bring people out of the woodwork, bring people, contacts, relationships, associations from our past into our present again. Now it gets interesting because on December 7th, we have Venus moving into Aquarius. So fellow air sign energy for you, which is very nice. The moment she steps into Aquarius, she meets up with Pluto, who of course is now in Aquarius for the next 20 years, no more backsliding into Capricorn. So this is your ninth house of the big picture perspective, where you see yourself going. It involves things like publishing contracts, international business contracts, the internet, law, legal, spirituality, the higher mind, all of those, academia, all of those types of energies for the ninth house. With Mercury retrograde in that seventh house of other people, there could be news from the December 7th to the 15th of somebody from your past recontacting you about some powerful Venus conjunct Pluto opportunity in the areas I just mentioned. When Venus conjuncts Pluto, it's very interesting because it can signal some sort of powerful money association. Now, Pluto is about power, absolutely. Pluto rules your sixth house of work. So there could be some interesting expansion of something connected to your past that you're kind of working on that could be a very powerful new beginning for expanding ninth house, your career aspirations, like what you see is possible for yourself. So this could be offered by somebody else, but it also could be you contacting somebody from your past or going back and doing something from your past that will achieve a future result. I like concrete examples, so here is one. There's a Gemini I know who has just redone all the rewards, right? Redone their resume so that they can apply for the next level up in their career at their current job, which is associated with one of those areas. I'm not going to say which one, but they are contacting people from their past within this organization to arrange the testing times, the one-on-one face-to-face meetings for the preliminary interviews to go to the next level. So this is very indicative. And this person sees themselves, you know, expanding into the next level for their career. So it fits with the energy. And this person does not follow astrology. But because I know them, I just laugh because I'm like, textbook case of the aspects currently playing out in the sky. So it's powerful energy, Venus conjunct Pluto. It really could be a powerful money possibility as well, especially maybe also in regards to your creativity, because Venus rules your fifth house of creativity, Libra, and it also rules your fifth house of the entrepreneur, Libra. So if you have your own business, I mean, there could be a powerful new contact, a powerful new client, a new business connection. Again, it may have a thread to the past, it's possible, that comes into play around the 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th. And of course, your personal full moon is happening December 15th. I will do a separate full moon video, but I think this full moon is going to be very interesting because it's the same day that Mercury goes direct, and Mercury's your ruling planet, is your personal full moon. It is a Sunday when that full moon occurs, so you may hear news, you know, a little before, a little after, but I think this could be a very pivotal month for you, Gemini. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel. I was looking at my analytics, and like half the people who watch the channel are not subscribed. So if you hit that subscribe, you will be notified and the bell when I release that full moon in Gemini video. You don't want to miss that. You want to get the inside scoop on what you need to know about that energy. All right, let's see what you need to know. Let's pull some cards. Gemini. I mean, do you have that experience? Like, you kind of like know some astrology, whatever, or whatever, and you see certain things playing out in somebody's life that, you know, and you want to tell them, oh, that's Pluto, or this is that, or whatever. But if you did, they would think you were crazy or whatever, because they maybe they're not as, you know, up to speed with astrology as you are. Kind of hard having normies as friends, right? We love them, but it's hard sometimes. Here you are, Queen of Swords and the Seven of Cups, working on manifesting those dreams. High Priestess in your heart, the Four of Swords, and the Six of Coins. There's that Libra. There's something that is in process here. It is absolutely in process. I'm getting chills down my legs. I'm getting, you know, I always get a little blurb in my ear. Don't sleep on your dreams is what I am getting in my ear, okay? Because we do have energies of sleep and dreams right in here. So this is not a time for you to do that. It's not a time to sleep on your dreams. It will be a time this month to get your dreams in order, to make those dreams manifest in a fair and equitable way, in a balanced way. And because we have the Libra scales here, and because you're a Gemini, and it's always with you about two things, there could be two very important dreams coming to fruition, negotiations, things happening. One may be a little stronger than the other. I mean, the scales are not equal. There is one scale that's a little more pronounced, whatever, and that's fine. It doesn't mean both of them are bad or one's better than the other. But one may just have more of a weight than the other, but they're both good. Okay, so we have you here. We have the Seven of Cups, which is wishes, choices, bucket lists. We have the High Priestess in your heart, which can be about keeping your own counsel and really intuitively tuning in with alignment and what you want and getting strong, profound messages from your dreams. Here is the Four of Swords. So I would say this first quarter moon, all right, here she is, the Priestess. And this, she always looks like Gemini to me in this card with the gateway here. Okay, tuning in with the first quarter moon, especially with what your dreams are telling you, what your spidey sense is telling you, what your intuition is telling you, what you feel aligned in your gut with, whatever way you get your intuitive information. Okay, you want to get yourself correctly aligned for whatever is going to be offered to you. Here it is. And with the Libra, it can be a partnership, a contract, a connection. It could be a, you know, something to do with the law, like taking a test or, you know, getting a certificate, you know, something that's legally binding, like that says, okay, this is, you can do this now. Like you get your nail technician license or, you know, something like that. Gemini rules the hands. That's why I said that, right? Like you're like, now you can go and do this. So it can be something like that, but this is a very benevolent energy. And if it's not somebody literally giving you something, it can be the universe that is gifting you with something that is very much aligned with your dreams. And it could be two things, but I feel like because of the Libra, I just feel like it's probably going to be something a lot more tangible, like a contract signing up for something. Excuse me. I got to take a sip of my tea. You know, a contract, you know, something where you're signing on the dotted line, very Libra. I think it's so interesting. I just got a glitch in my throat. I think that's important for you. I think there's something here about speaking up and claiming your truth and speaking out and speaking up for what you want to manifest and negotiating for yourself, perhaps, with this, whatever this is. I mean, it's good. Whatever's being offered to you is good. But because of the Six of Coins, it could be something that is a little bit of a negotiation. And also we have your Queen of Swords energy, which she can be very much like bottom line and advocate for herself. So there is, like, don't sleep on your dreams. There is a dream that you're advocating for yourself when it comes to your money and career life that can have a tangible outcome. Don't let the frog get stuck in your throat. Don't let your desire and dream get stuck in your throat, right? Speak it into being. Speak to whomever you need to speak to. It might be you need to speak to yourself and speak it into being, but you could also need to be having a conversation with somebody to speak it into being, like negotiation or something like that. So I think this is very, very interesting. There is some internal work going on here for you this month. Okay, but again, I feel like this is probably before the 7th with the 7 here. I think the 7th to the 15th is when this news, this manifestation is going to start rolling in, because yours was the first energy and we know we have a full moon, your full moon on the 15th. All right, Gemini, let's tune in with this oracle deck and see what else you need to know. And also, I mean, it could just be too, you do need a little rest, you know, with that High Priestess, Seven of Cups, Four of Swords energy. You may just need a little mental, I feel it's more mental downtime than necessarily physical, but you kind of may need to just take a day to have kind of a mental health day, a breather from all the stuff that is getting ready to pop in your world with that full moon. All right, so let's see what else we need to know. We have the Matrix. Ooh, the Matrix, revealing the truth, sacred work, real career, muse, catalyst, and possibilities. Okay, that's interesting. So yes, some truth will be revealed at your full moon. As we know, there may be something where, yes, you are stepping into some sort of sacred work, your real career. Like I said, if you're finally getting that certificate, like maybe you were working just whatever type job to pay your bills. You were not really that into it, but you got your certificate to, you know, do nails. Let's just use that example. Now that, and you consider that your real work, now you're able to go out and do that. So that's beautiful. We have muse, catalyst, and possibilities. There's some sort of catalyzing event, right? There's some sort of Six of Coins situation that shifts the reality, shifts things out of dream and into tangible. That's what I feel with this energy. But let's pull another few tarot cards and see what we have. That big full moon is a catalyst for you. I love that word, catalyst. All right, let's see. Gemini. All right, what do we need to know? The Matrix. Catalyst and possibilities. There you are. King of Swords. You showed up as Queen of Swords before. Isn't that interesting? Three of Cups. Page of Cups in your heart. The Sun card and the Two of Wands. This is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Very nice. So we have your third house of communications showing up here. Your third house of contracts, the Leo, the mind, making deals go down. So you have the new beginning in your heart, the Page of Cups. Our Pisces energy, which is your 10th house of career. Three of Cups is also a Pisces energy for me. That is your 10th house of career as well. Notice before we started with the Queen of Swords. Now we're starting with the King of Swords. So while of course the Queen of Swords can be a dynamic energy, I mean, she is a yin energy, right? She's the feminine. Okay. And the King is the masculine. He is the yang energy. So he is outward. Queen is inward. Doesn't mean the Queen can't do anything. Okay. But you get my point, right? So this is absolutely the outward action taking now of this situation, right? It is the catalyst. The new possibilities are happening. They're coming in joyfully and you're deciding on them joyfully and you're claiming it for yourself and it is happening. And also this Page of Cups in your heart. This is such a beautiful energy. I love the Page of Cups because it is a tender new beginning. And that's what's in your heart. It's a joyful. I mean, we have two cards of joy, Three of Cups and the Sun card. So this is beautiful. There is a joyful new beginning. It might be artistic in nature because we had the Libra. That's your fifth house of creativity. So it could be connected with, you know, your creative life force energy, your creativity. I think we had that in here. We had Muse and, you know, so your creative muse is on fire. Maybe you're working on a book or it's published or something with some sort of creative effort is getting recognition. It's going to be getting out into the world. There's a deal for it. You know, it could be something like that, but it's gorgeous. It's beautiful. And again, contracts with this, the Sun card. This is very nice. And contracts with him too. So when I say contracts, I think most of the time when I say that, I do think of paperwork, like a literal, you sign your name. But contracts also in the larger scheme of things, the metaphor is like a sacred contract. Right, we have sacred work here. It could be a sacred contract that you are signing with the universe, that you are stepping into, you know, your next chapter of what you're doing for your career with joy and love and happiness and all good things manifesting for you. So, and it could be a sacred contract that you're having with somebody else, right? That you're going to work in tandem with somebody, a new boss, new coworkers, you know, something like that. So whichever way it applies to your life, as I say, apply the energies to your life. We have the Two of Wands here, which is interesting at the end. I think what this is, you see, she's standing there with her cell phone. To me, what this is saying, and we have the Leo next to it, it may take time for everything to fully develop, but there is a catalyzing event. There is a catalyst in the matrix of your life this month where you see the seeds of change are here because we have a Mars retrograde, which is going to last until the middle of February, I believe, middle end-ish of February. So it may just be this Two of Wands could possibly just be slow down in holiday time. Okay. Which, as you know, people check out in the holidays. So the last 2 weeks of December could just be you're contacting people, you're trying to get things done, but it's a Two of Wands. It's still in the planning stage. Nothing is quite, you know, happening yet, but things are happening, but they're not in the process of being built yet. Okay. The yes has been received, but the building needs to be begun. The building will start perhaps after Mars gets out of retrograde in Leo, which happens, I believe, like the middle-ish of January, goes back into Cancer. So it could be just a delay until like after the new year type energy when things then hit the ground running. But I wouldn't worry about this Two of Wands at all. Just that there may be additional planning, organization, you know, things like that that you're getting underway. But I think this is a very favorable energy, Gemini, of tender new beginnings that are joyful in you manifesting something near and dear to your heart that's fully aligned for you. Because whenever I have a king and queen matching like this, when I'm doing a money reading, to me, that is like your energy is both things. Like you feel aligned with it, with your flow energy, the feminine, and you feel aligned with it, with your active, assertive energy, which is the king energy. So it ticks all the boxes. So Gemini, leave me a comment. Let me know what's going on for you with these energies. I would love to hear how you plan on using them to manifest your wildest dreams, because that is what it is all about, to step into the energy of the possibilities that I bring out here with the astrology and the tarot, so that you can claim that energy and you can use it to inspire your own life. That's what it's all about. So I love you guys. Can't wait to hear what's going on for you. If you like the video, please consider giving it a thumbs up. Sharing it out with people really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And please consider subscribing. Half of the viewers are not subscribed. It takes 2 seconds. Hit that little subscribe button and the bell, and you'll get notified when I put out new videos. As I said before, you don't want to miss your full moon in Gemini video. So until next time, love you guys. Take care. I'll see you again soon. Stella Wild, signing out.